Using Kanban boards every day was a game changer for me, but it was when I learned to use them the right way that my productivity skyrocketed. When I started, I made so many mistakes that held me back. That's why this video is here, to help you avoid these pitfalls and make the most out of Kanban from the start. At first, I thought the more tasks I put on the Kanban board, the more productive I'd be. But the reality was the opposite. The board became overwhelming, and it was hard to prioritize what needed to be done. Instead, I should have focused on limiting the work in progress. Kanban works best when you cap the number of tasks in each column, allowing you to focus on completing tasks rather than just adding more. By setting a work in progress limit, I could have avoided that clutter and kept the board and myself more organized. I also didn't prioritize my tasks effectively. Everything seemed equally important, which meant nothing really got the attention they needed. This made it easy to get stuck on less important tasks, while critical ones lingered. Now I know how crucial it is to categorize tasks by their importance and urgency. Using the priority levels in Kanbanchi, I can clearly see what needs immediate attention and what can wait. I can even have my Kanban board reorganized based on the priority levels. Another big mistake I made was not updating my board regularly. I would create tasks and then forget to move them as I progressed. This meant the board didn't reflect the true state of my projects, making it almost useless. Kanban is a dynamic tool. It requires regular updates. Now I make it a habit to move tasks as soon as they progress to the next stage. This keeps the board accurate and ensures everyone knows exactly where things stand. I used to put entire projects as one single task on the board, thinking it would simplify things. But this just made tasks feel unmanageable and the progress slow. Now, I break down large tasks into smaller, more manageable pieces. This not only makes the work feel more achievable, but also allows me to track short-term progress more accurately. If big tasks are not broken down into smaller ones, it is impossible to tell their current status. Linear movement is central to Kanban, and once a task starts moving forward, it should never go back. But in the beginning, I would regularly move tasks back to columns to the left after they had already advanced in the process. For example, when I hit a roadblock, I would move the task back to backlog. It may not seem all that relevant, but it sends a message that it is okay to start tasks and not see them through. Having work in progress limitation as a central aspect, Kanban demands commitment when a task is started. At one point, I treated my Kanban board like a glorified to-do list. I didn't utilize its full potential, which meant I missed out on many of the benefits Kanban offers. Kanban is much more than just a list of tasks. It is a tool for visualizing workflows, identifying bottlenecks, and improving efficiency. By using features like swim lanes, labels, and due dates, I can now create a board that truly helps manage my projects from start to finish. One of the core principles of Kanban is continuous improvement, but at first, I didn't fully embrace this. I set up my board and just left it as it was, without considering how I could make it better as processes evolved. Now, I review my Kanban boards regularly, looking for ways to improve them. Whether it's adjusting WIP limits, reorganizing columns, or even changing the layout, small tweaks can lead to significant improvements in productivity. Don't be afraid to create a new list in the middle of the project. As long as it helps with the workflow, go for it! Kanban is a powerful tool, but only if you use it effectively. By learning from these common pitfalls, you can set yourself up for success and truly transform your workflow. And if you'd like to try an amazing Kanban board, click on the link in the description and get Kanbanchi now at a 40% discount.